website www.tarotbyanisha.com, and this is your monthly forecast for June 2014. Taurians, this month we have a lot of influence of Venus, that is your ruling planet, and we have two planets that are going retrograde, that is Mercury and Neptune. We begin this month with Mars and Pluto that are squaring up to each other, and it could make you feel quite conflicted between doing the done thing and what your really heart desires to do. You could be caught between the obligations and the responsibilities of what is expected out of you, but on the other hand, you may be wanting to just cut loose and run away and do things that really you've been wanting to do for the longest of time. Now this month also we have beginning of the month we have Venus that gets active, and we could have more than one person who could be interested in you, and you could be feeling quite charismatic and quite romantic as we begin the month. There's also a new moon in Gemini, and this is accentuating a part of your chart that has to do with finances and material comfort. It's a good time, Taurians, for you to be looking at your investments, reallocating budgets. For those of you who have been thinking of investing further or have a property where you have just invested, you could be either redoing it, or there could be some remodeling or furnishing or some amount of money that you could be spending in a real estate. And so you could be planning as to how it is that you want to allocate your budgets, what it is that you want to do. It's a good month also to be looking at your financial goals, planning it. Maybe it will be worth your while to be hiring somebody who's a CA or somebody who's really, helps a family with planning of the money and who could help you plan your budget. It's also a great time where you could be pampering yourself and wanting to, there's just a sense of starting fresh, Taurians. And I think that's a great thing. A lot of you could be feeling quite invigorated, re-energized, and there'll be a sense of purpose, a new sense of, you know, everything will have a sort of newness around it. So whether it is that you have just changed a new house, or you've moved cities, or it's a new job, a new place, but there's just a sense of, you know, you starting fresh. Mercury is going retrograde from 7th of June till about 1st of July, and Mercury is cautioning you to rethink, revise, and re-look at your plans that you may have, especially as far as finances are concerned and your material comforts are concerned. Mercury is cautioning you not to rush into, especially if they're financial obligations or if it's a loan that you're looking at picking up. It's not a great time to be rushing into things, taking quick decisions. It is, however, a great time for those of you who have invested and the investments are not really paying off. It's a good time to be liquidating that. It is also a good time to get away for a little while, and it could be in a lap of luxury. It could be one of these luxurious resorts that you decide to go, or it could be maybe just a day's spa or a weekend away at a... It's a good time to sort of pamper yourself and spend good money on yourself. Even food is accentuated. A lot of you could either be really be getting into food and cooking up new recipes, new dishes, or some of you could be really visiting new restaurants and exploring exotic food. Taurians, it's also a good time to be streamlining your finances. So while as soon as you realize that in case there is a shortage of funds that's happening, don't hesitate to reallocate. So if there is an extra additional house in which you're not living, which is there for an investment, don't hesitate to liquidate it and take the money. Don't wait for the last minute for some sort of a help to come, or don't hesitate that, oh, maybe in the next 5 years, 6 years, the value will get appreciated and that is the time I will liquidate it. Use this time to streamline your money. It'll help you a lot in your day-to-day thing, and it'll just help life flow far more better around you. Now, Neptune starts going backward towards the 9th of June, and Neptune is up to no good. It is, since it's retrograde, the entire deception, delusion, the dreamlike quality gets really, really accentuated. And this has to do with a part of your chart that deals with groups of people or clubs. So for those of you who are a part of, say, a large group, it can be anything. It can be a club, it can be your running group, it can be anything which you are really passionate about, and it could be that you have been really sitting and idolizing this group and or the voice of this group. You know, you feel quite I wouldn't say pressured, but for some time you could have been pretty much been doing what the group is saying. You know, everybody says, okay, today we will go and climb that X mountain, you know, which you may not be wanting to do. You may think, you know, it's not really the best thing to be doing. You could be doing something else. Maybe you could be going for cycling, as simple things as that. And this is a time where Neptune is saying, you know, listen to your voice, listen to your inner voice, listen to your own wisdom. It's good to have a group of people. It's good to be associated with a larger community. But it is wise also to listen to what it is that your own gut and your own mind or even facts say. Neptune accentuation also speaks that the lesser you move, or everything, since it gets dreamlike and everything is very soft and rosy, you must have your facts and your figures with you, Taurians. It's a try not to get too swayed away by the public opinion this month, you know. So whether, and especially for those of you who are traveling this month, be extremely careful that you know, there is a Mercury retrograde which deals with your communication, travel and technology. And then you have a Neptune, which is also accentuating a part, you know, which has to do with travel and has to do with groups of people. Try not to get too swayed or to get too awed by the advertising that is happening around you for what the club or the group is claiming. So keep your wits about, use your own judgment, have the facts and figures before you take a decision, or before you sort of feel pressure or you feel, yes, that is the done thing. It may not be so. Also, as far as I think, as far as friendships are concerned, try not to go by the public poll as to how it is that you should be dealing with your friendships. I think, Taurians, it's extremely important that even if there has been hearsay on certain friendships, on how a certain person is or how you should be with an ex-friend, I think it is wiser and it is fair to be using your own experience, your own past experience and your judgment as to how it is that you should be dealing with your friends and not the public poll. We have Venus that is going on a opposition with Saturn, which is focusing on a recent or a current relationship, one of a close intimate relationships. And issues around sex and money could crop up, and especially if there have been issues already around this area, it could get a little unpleasant. The planets are advising you to keep the dialogue open, Taurians. It's not a great time to be saying that, oh, I can't deal with this anymore and I don't want to be dealing with this, and just shut the topic and leave it for later. It's important that you leave the dialogue open, have conversations around it, and try and see, try and maneuver your way as to what is the solution that can come out of it. Because this is something which later in the year can come up quite aggressively, and you will have to address it, and it may not be too pleasant. So it's a good time right now if in an intimate relationship you have been grappling for answers and you've been trying to wonder, you know, how is it that it could be that they're absolutely different value systems as well with this particular person. It's just that now, right now, it is you know, it's just coming out and it's there right on your face. So keep the dialogue open. Try not to get too confrontational. Try not to be too defensive. Give it a good hearing. Keep your mind open and give the other person a chance to say his or her own bit as well. So overall, a good month, Taurians. For those of you who can travel, it's a good time, I think, to take a quick getaway and be closer to nature as much as possible. It'll take care of your nerves. For those of you who have not tried yoga or meditation, it's a good month to be giving a shot at it. As the month ends, in any case, Sun is going to be coming up around the 23rd. So it is going to be bringing around a lot of clarity on what the future plans can be. So have a great month. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you.